Chris Stevenson, Interior Coachman of the QMI Agency here in Ufa, Russia for the World Junior Hockey Championship. And Terry, an off day for Team Canada today, but that didn't mean there wasn't quite a bit of news. And I guess at the top of the list is word that the IIHF has decided to suspend Team Canada forward JC Lipan for one game because of his hit to the head against Slovakia on Friday.
Yeah, he'll miss the game against the Americans, obviously, Chris, and he's pretty disappointed about it, as any player would be. A little bit emotional speaking to reporters about it today. And a couple of tough things for him to consider now. He's got to work his way back into the good graces of Coach Steve Spott, because no matter what Spott says about the call, and he did say today that he thought it was more a two-minute minor more than anything else, the fact is he does lose a forward.
Yeah.
A forward who has to adjust better to what's going on over here and what's being called here. So it's it hurts Canada, there's no doubt about that. There's 11 forwards now for the game against the Americans. Boone Jenner serves the final game of his three-game suspension. So, you know, nice for these guys to have a full lineup, but they have to learn the rules first.
Yeah, and it's going to be it was going to be a tall order anyway against the Americans, and certainly you could have used Lipan's physical presence against a team that's going to play a similar, obviously North American style, mm-hmm. as to what the Canadians played. From what you've seen in the first two games, Terry, how do you think the Canadians match up against the Americans, who played a great game against the Russians last night and wound up coming out on the short end of the score?
Well, it's going to be a close game, Chris. I don't think there's any doubt about that. The one advantage right now that the Americans might have could be in goal. John Gibson has looked a lot more composed than Malcolm Subban has here for the first couple of games of the tournament.
Yep.
Gibson playing really well against the Russians, and you know, the game-winning goal that he allowed wasn't his fault or anything like that, but just the composure Gibson has shown. He plays for the Kitchener Rangers back in the Ontario Hockey League, so Steve Spott knows him quite well. Gibson's wearing his Rangers mask over here while he's playing, but it's, you know, of course, hockey comes down to goaltending a lot. I think it really could in this game. I mean, I think the forwards are pretty well evenly matched, as the defensemen as well. So this is a game that I know Canadian fans are looking to Malcolm Subban to kind of step it up a bit.
Yeah, I think that's going to probably be the biggest focus of this game, because they've won their first two games against the Germans and the Slovaks, but you know, I don't think you could say that Subban looked totally in control.
No.
In either of those games. There were a lot of you know, loose pucks down around his feet and a few too many rebounds.
Well, he did, and you should keep in mind, too, that a lot of, you know, some of the people I talked to before the tournament began said that Canada might be able to, though the offensive power they have, get away with allowing 3-4 goals a game, so they're going to score enough. Now, we've seen that, of course, against Germany and Slovakia, but it doesn't really matter. Now you're playing the Americans and the Russians,
yeah.
And really you have to clamp down defensively.
Yep, a big couple of days coming up for Canada, game against USA on Sunday, and then New Year's Eve game against the Russians. So it's going to be an interesting couple of days. Stay tuned to all of the Sun newspaper websites. In Ufa, Russia, at the World Junior Championships for the QMI Agency, I'm Chris Stevenson, along with Terry Koshin.